Good evening, Louisiana Bourbon Collective. We're back. The final region of the 2020 Bourbon of the Year Blind Bracket Challenge, Region 5. We're down to it. We are two nights away from the Bourbon of the Year Championship. That'll be crowned Thursday night. Who will get it? Bourbon of the Year 2020. A few things before we get started. Special shout out goes out to the wife, Stephanie. She has filmed every single one of these episodes. She does all the blind setup. She sets up the bottles, does all the pretty stuff, makes it look good. Special shout out to her for dealing with this whole thing. She's been a good sport. So, wanted to give her a special shout out. Two, listen up closely. So, I'm going to do a giveaway. It's going to be a sample pack. It'll be a 1 ounce sample of each of the Whiskey of the Year finalists. Now, the way you win it is randomly. It could be this video, the Bourbon of the Year video, or the Whiskey video. I'm randomly going to say keyword, and that keyword after that is going to be the keyword. Randomly throughout the week, I'm going to put up a post in the LBC that says, what's the password? What's the keyword? The first 25 people to comment that word is going to go into the running to win a sample pack of the Whiskey of the Year Final Blind. So that's to make sure everybody's watching. It's going to be random. You never know when it's going to come up. I'm not even going to hint it. It's just going to come out of my mouth. Remember it. And when you see the post, the first 25 people will go into a randomizer, and I'll mail that pack to you free of charge. So let's go over the contenders. We had a little switch. Elijah Craig Toasted Barrel is not in this. We had a latecomer. I got a late addition that I really wanted into the tournament. We got it, and boy, it did not disappoint. So we have a one seed A and a one seed B. The one seed A, the Old Kirk, coming in at 125.4 proof, 6 years, 9 months, cannot confirm or deny purple top Willet juice here. One seed B, the Four Roses 2020 LE. This one comes in at 111 proof. So, the two seed, the Sam Houston 14-year-old. This one is 98 proof. Let me tell you something. If this was cask strength, man, these were expensive. These were about 150 retail. I'm going to tell you what, this was cask strength. I might have tried to get some more of these. This is the batch from Florida, so there's different batches from different states. So if I know a few guys got them. The one that's in this flight is a bottle 150 of only 510. It's the Florida batch. There was only three barrels in that batch, and this is the 14 year from that Florida batch. So if you have that batch, that one is in region 5 as the 2 seed. The 3 seed, the Old Forester 150, batch 3. This one comes in at 126.8. We all know how batch 2 did with a huge surprise, tying George T. Stagg to get into the final of the Bourbon of the Year. Shout out to Jackie Zeichel. She's doing some incredible things over at Brown-Forman, specifically Old Forester. She's picking the barrels for these. I have not had the birthday bourbon from this year. She picked it for that. I've heard that was disappointing. I've heard it's great. You hear different things, different people. I didn't get a chance to try it or get it, but I did get the Old Forester 150s. I did get batch 1, but batch 2, batch 3, as you saw, batch 2 blind, incredible. The last seed in this region, this is another Old Forester. This is the single barrel strength from Lincoln Road Package Store in Hattiesburg. I know everybody keeps asking Hattiesburg, what's... I'm a USM graduate. I went to the University of Southern Mississippi. I graduated from there. My wife is a USM graduate. She is actually born and raised in Hattiesburg. I brought her back with the diploma. So We get a lot of picks from Lincoln Road. Jamie's actually a friend of the family, so we like to support him, and he does great picks. This one comes in at 127.8 proof. So here we go, Region 5. Let's get it going, left to right. Here we go. That one's bright. Dark fruits. Very, very fruity, pungent fruit. But real light on the nose. Not a lot of, not dark caramel or anything like that. A lot of fruits. A little bit of pine, citrus. A little bit of oak on the back end. Cinnamon, clove, getting that clove again. A lot of baking spices. That one pops. Let's see. Man, palate totally different. The nose was light. Palate, very viscous. Real sweet on the front end. The caramel really comes through with that dark fruit hint, that citrus. And now on the back end, it's a minty, like a minty effervescent on the tongue. Not cinnamon, not pepper. It's very minty. So my guess would be a little rye on that one, but first one, really good. Write that one down. All right, number two. Okay, this one's a lot darker. Brown sugar, dark caramel. Apple. A little hint of apricot. Some people get peach. I get apricot a lot. I don't get too much peach. I mean, it has to be maybe one of the Four Roses barrel picks to get a little peach, but I pick up apricot. Apricot, those dried prunes. So this one's pretty fruity, but with a lot of caramel and a lot of cinnamon on it as well. Same thing on the palate. Tons of fruit. Tons of fruit. This one has that cinnamon spice on it, like red hots. Cinnamon red hots. Big time cinnamon red hots on the back end. Fruit front, dark, dark fruit, apricots, prunes on the front, cinnamon on the back. Both of those had really prickly finishes on them. I have to take water on that one. All right. Oh, that's good news. So this one's real sweet. Almost picking up a hazelnut, like that Nutella. But at the same time, fruits. But yeah, that Nutella. Nutella and fruit. That's the best way to describe this one. Man. Wow. Chocolate covered orange. I don't know if you had those ones where you break it open and has the orange pieces in it. That's what I'm getting on that. A lot of citrus, a lot of chocolate. Not a good finish. I don't get that spicy finish on the back, but man, that is just straight chocolate orange on that one. So maybe that hazelnut was coming through as a chocolate on the nose. But definitely on the palate, plain as day. Oh, okay, so this one's deep, deep sugar, brown sugar, burnt sugar almost. A little bit more of that chocolate, a little hint of chocolate, oak. Man, what is that? Definitely fruits. I want to say apple, but as soon as I say apple, it turns dark, more like raisin. It's sweet though. Sweet like those like the golden raisins, not the dark ones. Man, bitter chocolate. So that's two. These two both had a little chocolate on it. Blind, it's crazy getting the different notes you get, and then you figure out which one it was. And I think back, and I'm like, man, when I had this on its own, I didn't get that. But when you get it blind, you definitely get different notes. I'm definitely interested to see which one these two are coming through with all this chocolate. This one's bitter dark chocolate. This was a little bit more hazelnut, sweeter. This is definitely a dark chocolate, lots of fruit. Not too complex though. So fifth and final one, first time around. Oh. Man. Apples, oranges, apricot. A lot of apricot tonight. Oh man, cinnamon, heavy cinnamon. A little bit of dough. It's almost coming across like a cinnamon roll. Palate's caramel. This one's really light. Light on the palate. It has a good palate, but real light, no finish. But the flavors are there. Man, this is going to be tough. First, I don't even know. Damn, I don't have one that stood out as a leader, and I don't have one that stood out as a loser. These two, second time around, getting some nuttiness on this one. Heavy almond on the second time around on this one. I like that. I'm a big wedding cake fan. That is my favorite dessert. So when I taste almond on a bourbon, oh man, heavy citrus, that chocolate orange. Okay. This one's getting eliminated. Let me tell you something. I don't know what this is. This is a good bourbon. But when you do a blind tasting, finish and mouthfeel can really come through, and this one just does not have that mouthfeel like these other ones do. The finish on all four of these is incredible. So, fifth place. Let's try to eliminate. This one's going through. This one's going through. So let's try to. These noses are similar. Just because, once again, this has the better mouthfeel and finish. So we're down to the final three. At this point, the notes, you know, they matter, but when you get down to the final three, you let them go head to head, you see which one comes through and shines, and you just go with it. So here we go. Who's going to come out of Region 5? God, that's cinnamon. This is the best nose. Oh, God. Butter on the palate. That nuttiness, almond, hazelnut. I don't know if this is the one, but man, that chocolate Nutella is really coming through on that. Final two. Man, I have no guess. In this region, I have zero guess on what any of these are. The other ones, I could, you know, I didn't guess them all, obviously, but, you know, I could get it close. I have zero guesses. This could be, this is wide open. Wide open. I thought for sure the Four Roses would stick out. It has not, unless it wins, it could possibly win, but I thought the Four Roses would stick out. All right, let's really get into these two because this is going to be very hard. God, I love that nose on that one. Oh, it's crazy what that coffee does. It really does reset the nose. There is region 5 is complete. I can't wait to see this one. Out of all the regions, this one I'm the most excited to see about because none of them stood out as like a really just this is number one. So this is some good. I knew these were good bourbons, but blind, tough. All right, in fifth place. A respectable fifth place. The Sam Houston 14 year. The only thing that held that back, like I said, was the proof. At 98 proof on its own, you drink that by itself, it's going to be incredible. But you put it up against a blind, obviously that's going to hold it back when you're going, I mean, the 115 plus, that's going to be tough. Fourth place. The Four Roses LE comes in fourth place. You know, I have to agree. Two of the guys I watch the most, Mash and Drum, Jason C. and Mash and Drum, Fred Minnick. Both of those guys, Four Roses, does not do well in their blind tastings. They do well in their own. They're great bourbons. 2019 won Mash and Drum's Bourbon of the Year, but he doesn't do a blind. But both of them agree that Four Roses does not do well in blinds, and here we go, fourth place. Incredible. That, man. All right. In third place of Region 5, the Old Kirk. Man. So down goes both one seeds. So the streak of one seeds ends here tonight, Region 5. We got a double Old Forester. I swear to God, Old Forester 150. The champion of Region 5. And moving on to the bourbon final is Old Forester Lincoln Road. How you like that? A barrel pick. This won the play-in game. So I had a play-in game. It was Lincoln Road versus the Hocus Pocus pick. How you like that? So the Old Forester, Jamie Ferris, Lincoln Road Package Store. This is Warehouse K 43. Comes through as the winner in Region 5. Guys, when you do stuff blind, I tell you what, it's fun. I've had a blast doing this. It started out as a fun little thing. We're just going to do it for the group. But the feedback has been so positive. Appreciate all the views. Subscribe. Share it with your friends. We got big things coming in 2021. This channel is going to be educational. We're going to do interviews. We're going to do all kinds of stuff. I got a bunch of plans coming for 2021, guys. I've had a blast doing this. Man, Region 5, the Old Forester barrel pick. Barrel strength comes through. Obviously, Old Forester 150 comes in second. By themselves, the Old Foresters, I was disappointed in the Old Forester 150. I cannot lie. Both Batch 2 and Batch 3, I was disappointed. But in blind tastings, obviously, they showed through. One is going to the final. One came in second place. Easily could have been either one. But this one took it. So, two videos left. Bourbon of the Year 2020. That'll be Thursday night. Get ready for it. Bourbon of the Year 2020, Thursday night. And then, on location, at the Circle Bar in Madisonville, Louisiana, Whiskey of the Year 2020 coming at you, LBC. Can't wait to do it. Y'all have a great night. Pop 'em. Don't watch 'em.